Hi guys, so let's talk about neutrals for the undertones. So the thing with wearing colors for your undertone is that you really only need to wear your own colors right next to your face. So if these neutral colors don't really resonate with you, don't worry about it. Just try to incorporate some colors either in jewelry, you know, or at doing your makeup within your own colors, or wearing maybe at some top with your own color or a scarf in your own color. So don't worry too much if some of these colors don't resonate with you, and let's get right into it. So for warm and radiant, the warmest skin undertone, we really don't have too many neutrals because they look amazing in warm and bright colors. We're talking about yellows, we're talking about bright salmons and corals and things like that, and even lime greens. They look amazing and they just light up in these colors. But that's why neutrals can sometimes drag them down a tiny bit. So what we want when we're thinking about neutrals is to incorporate a fair amount of yellow into the color because their skin undertone has a lot of yellow to it, and that's why it has that warm, bright glow. So we want to think about the tans being really quite golden as you can get in a tan. You'd be surprised. Some tans can be really quite golden, and you can also go for browns that are a bit more orange. So, you know, those browns that look really rich and as orange as you can go, and you'd be surprised how even a burnt orange on you might actually look like a brown because your undertone is so bright. For a lighter neutral as warm and radiant, you can go for a cream. And again, the more yellowish a cream is, the better. So you want to stay away from ivory and lean more toward cream. So those are your neutrals. But again, if you don't like them, that's totally okay. You can borrow any colors from any other undertone and just put some of your own colors near your face. So just remember that and don't freak out if you don't like your neutrals. So now when we get a little bit less warm, we're a little bit closer to neutral, we have warm and delicate. So warm and delicate looks amazing in some warm and muted colors. The kings and queens of neutrals, basically. So they look amazing in warm grays. They look amazing in some slightly warm tans, but really any tans would do for warm and delicate. Warm browns look amazing on them, beiges, camels, so those earth tones, creams, ivories, they all look amazing on warm and delicate. If you're warm and delicate, you really want to lean more toward ivory. Ivory is amazing on warm and delicate, but cream can sometimes work as well. So now as we cross over neutral and we get to slightly cool, so these undertones are slightly cool, cool and delicate. So cool and delicate looks amazing in charcoal grays, in some light grays, in some cool browns. So those are all amazing options for cool and delicate, and definitely your best white. If you have not tried this white yet and you are cool and delicate, then seriously, try it out. This kind of off-gray white, and I even show this, I'm cool and delicate myself, and I show this in my draping video on me, and it just looks so wonderful on cool and delicate, this off-white, this grayish off-white. And of course, all of those cool grays as well. Do be careful as cool and delicate with warm grays. Warm grays are not going to look good on you, and you're going to be confused about why it is that they don't look good on you. And also be careful with grays that somehow look very, very bright. Sometimes if you are close to neutral as cool and delicate, and you find that some grays just don't look quite right on you, somehow they look too bright, that's actually possible. They might have a little bit too much blue for you or something like that. So play around with your grays and go for those neutral, slightly cool grays and not the very, very cool ones. And last but not least, the coolest undertone, we have cool and radiant. So cool and radiant is cooler than cool and delicate. So they look amazing in some cool and bright colors. So they can, of course, their neutrals are the workhorses of the neutrals. So they really look amazing in optic white and pure black. And pure black is cool and radiant's, one of cool and radiant's best colors. So if you are cool and radiant and you are complaining that, you know, you, beige really washes you out and things like that, please remember Optic White and Pure Black. And you are really the undertone that wears Pure Black by far the best. So just remember that. So that looks amazing on you, but you can also do a really, really crisp navy blue. That would be really amazing on you. And again, remember, if you don't like your neutrals, you can still mix them with some other colors. And you can also mix all of these neutrals together. So let's say if you like some other undertones neutrals, then you can incorporate, let's say if you're cool and radiant and you like beiges and tans, you can wear beiges and tans, but just incorporate maybe some crisp navy blue with that, you know, next to your face if you want like a very neutral outfit, or some black with some beige, you know, some pure black. So think about that, or Optic White, and think about how you can pair these neutrals and pair your best neutral near your face and put the rest away from your face and make them whatever you want, because the face is really the most important thing. That's what we look at. That's where we want our skin to glow. So don't be too upset if you totally hate your neutrals. Again, you can always mix and match with other colors. You can always include other neutrals that you like. As long as you really know what you're doing, you play around and, you know, you experiment and have fun with it. So that is it, you guys. I hope you enjoyed this video. Leave some comments down below, and I will talk to you next time. And also leave some video suggestions down below. And if you enjoy this type of content, I have a lot of exclusive content now on Mariam Style Club, where we have Q&A videos, we have a community. So if you're interested, I'll leave a link down below. And I will talk to you guys next time. Okay, bye.